presentation.
Oh, yeah, I saw your email, nice. And,
We'll open, and then you can talk.
All right, let's open.
Okay, so anyways, good evening and welcome to the Village of Webster Workshop, March 5th, 2019. Our primary point of discussion tonight on the agenda is the budget. But I would first of all open it up to Carl, who was able to go to, on Monday, a presentation in Penfield regarding the opioid epidemic and things that can be done by individuals as well as probably the community.
Yeah, thanks. The meeting, there were about 50 people there. Pretty good turnout. They had all kinds of good stuff to eat and drink. It was really good to start with. Kind of a mix and match before we got started. Police chief was there. There were members of the sheriff's department and New York State Health Department. And so we got about an hour and a half of really good talks, and it had to do with the problem, what's happening, and the solution that we have right now. It'll probably get better sometime or another, but for now, there was a lady there, and her name was Mary Beth Artuso, and she is Hispanic and deals in the Hispanic community. She has a doctorate degree in human psychology and drug abuse, and she really gave a really good talk. The opioid problem goes across all of our lives.
Speak, try to speak a little more on your mic. It's not picking it up.
Anywhere from doctors all the way to people on the street. And, the big thing that I got out of it was the availability of these opiates on the streets, and also freely given in the past up until now by doctors and anybody that had a license to prescribe opiates. And he described, or she described, in a bottle of heroin, it would take you maybe out of a vial that much to kill you. Then he showed fentanyl with only a couple little grains. And then most of the deaths in Mono County now are fentanyl related. And sometimes it's a synthetic opioid, and it's manufactured in the United States, but also mostly in China and Southeast Asia. and that's what's the big addiction is. I mean, you can't just take straight fentanyl, which is it looks just like heroin, but it would kill you. And it was shocking to me how little it takes to have an overdose and a death. And so at the end, there was a doctor there that, Mike Favada from the Sheriff's Department had some footage on the screen of approaching overdose victim. This guy deals primarily with overdose, and he just doesn't talk to the victim, but he gets information from the victim, and then they go out from there. They trace it out. And they're busting drug houses all over, and they're very advanced in the way they think about it and the way they do things, and undercover, a lot of undercover operations, and they're really, they're saying that opioid deaths this year so far are down because of their efforts. But it's also down because of the shortage on the streets, because these guys are doing their work.
He came to Hillside with Sheriff Baxter, and they did a presentation. And what
probably
I was
the same presentation.
Yeah, what I was in intrigued about was the age. It's not who you think it is.
Right.
That was really amazing.
It's 30 and 40.
Yeah, it was the 30 and 40 year olds where the biggest problem is. So that was shocking to me.
And this doctor brought up the fact that there's people that have chronic pain that really need to have this and nothing else will do. And they're offering acupuncture and various other alternative ways to conquer pain, pain management and all that stuff. And you guys have all had operations, we all have. And I know that when I had problems and got a shot or whatever it was just like, give me more. I mean, you want more right away.
Well, but they send you home with a bunch of pills, too.
Yeah, they do.
So, you know, and it's up to you. And then they say, oh, you can get another 3 months supply. Come on.
Yeah. So doctors are, you know, the medical field is working closely to try not to prescribe so many opioids. So anyway, they taught us how to use this Narcan. And each package comes with two small applicators. You hold it like a needle and pinch the thing in their nose. And you wait 2 to 5 minutes. And if it doesn't work, you do it a second time. So it's only one shot for each little applicator. It looks like the top of a hypodermic needle, but with a little pack of stuff that breaks open and goes in your nose. And they should recover with the first shot, but you can use the second one. If someone in your family should happen to accidentally take this, it's not going to harm anybody at all. If you don't use opiates, this won't harm you at all. So, you know, if your kids aren't getting into the medicine cabinet or something, you see this, you know, give it a shot, it's not going to hurt them. Very easy to use. You can get it for free. And I have all the information in this packet. I'll open it up and pass it around while we're talking. So I became a first responder with Narcan. And it's my belief that I think that everybody should carry this in their car, at least one box of this in their car. I mean, I even been driving along the street and saw somebody overdose on drugs after. But you never know when that could happen or where, you know, supermarkets, anywhere. And so there's little forms you fill out if you should administer it that Monroe County wants to see. But this is the information, and I'll pass it around for you guys and girls. There's information on where these overdosed people, when they're revived, can go to. There's all kinds of help available. And the big thing is they have to want to go. But most overdoses don't go back out on the street. They take them right to the hospital and give them immediate care. And then they bring a lot of people into the treatment center to go to rehab. And there was a guy from Huther Doyle that spoke last. And there's a great institution for addiction recovery, mostly alcoholic, but now starting on opiates and drug use. Yeah, and the problem that we have right now is that there's a lot of people going into rehab that need beds, and the beds aren't available. And so they have to wait. And if I were an addict, and I made up my mind that I want to go into care immediately, inpatient care, and I couldn't go because there wasn't a bed, and I went back home, chances are I'd go right back out and use it again.
That's in everything, though.
Yes.
Mental health. It is, yeah.
Everything.
Yes. Not enough beds. So the county health department is working on establishing part of a hospital, a whole wing of a hospital, so that they can handle them as to take care of all these people. And my daughter works in addiction and addiction recovery. She's a counselor, and she supervises 10 or 12 counselors, and that is their biggest problem. On a daily basis, if you don't have that, these people go to it. So they're working hard at that, and I was really impressed. Thank you.
We can look into that actually report here.
Yeah.
These guys may have, you know, come across needles and things around the church.
Here you go. You can open it up, we'll take a look. These are the little snifter thingies. You hold it like this.
Push.
Push.
And just push, yeah.
One shot, you don't have to do it, just one shot in the nose. And hit and move back, because once, this is almost instantaneous when it works. And the person that's on the floor doing this, receiving this, will start flailing and kicking and punching and everything. So, hit and get away.
Thank you, Carl. Okay. You want to start us off, Christina?
I guess I'll ask the board first, would you like to go through the budget line by line? Or do you have specific questions? How would you I'm open to whatever preference and format you'd like to go through.
I think we should just go with questions.
Yeah.
I don't think we need to go line by line. We all should have reviewed this several times. That's just my thought.
No, I agree.
I'm open to whatever questions you might have.
Daryl said he can keep us busy just to himself, so I guess there's his answer. We don't need to go
Let's start with Daryl then.
I think that's good.
We'll probably cover all the questions.
Yeah, let's start with you.
For the questions?
Yeah, and remember, it's only an hour meeting.
No, go Johnny then.
I will say, on the general fund budget, you will need to cross out, I had indicated on there.
What page?
Find it. An amount to pay the town back for the sewer piece, and Daryl had advised me that that would not yet be happening. So we have another $250,000 to play.
What page?
I'm looking.
Oh, sorry.
Well, that's perfectly good news.
Is it?
Be under,
I guess.
No, it would be in the general fund.
Under the general?
Find it. It's a small amount.
Not sure what it did under.
Okay.
It's sewer maintenance due to town.
Nine.
Yeah, page nine.
Page nine, $200,000 on middle of the page.
Yep, got it.
So that can be crossed off, it'll be updated at our meeting next week, but that adds, it takes away from the 402 and makes it 202.
Wow.
Yeah, good.
That is.
Wow, that's huge.
But it doesn't go away, just put off.
Right.
That had to do with the fact that they're going to be upgrading their generator and the chlorination station. And we do have a responsibility on that, one-third, because we, the generator keeps things going, and they need to upgrade that, and the chlorination, we have our effluent treated. So we are part of that as well. So that's going to go away. That was brought up. I think, a year and a half ago.
Yeah, I had made the note that it was going to be in this year's budget, and I wasn't sure. And you confirmed for me that it wouldn't be now, but next year.
They're just beginning.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, we had to really take note of that because it'll hit us next year. So next year will be 202 over.
I didn't know we had the burial permits.
Yeah.
That's something new to me.
Yes, guys.
Yeah, they pay us, but they pay us like, I don't know, 50 cents per permit.
Yeah.
Burial permits?
It's not a phenomenal.
So they're the ones that apply, not the families?
Correct.
Yeah,
oh, okay,
right.
Okay.
The funeral homes.
I don't ever remember applying for a permit to bury my mother or father.
No, the funeral home did that for you.
Right.
Yeah.
It was good in front of the
Naturally,
board.
I believe more and more it's happening online now. You're
yes.
not even having to come to the county
yeah.
office or village
oh,
okay. office anymore because it's all on. Everything's going online. Shopping, burial permits, I mean everything.
Yeah. cable TV franchise.
Oh, cable TV franchise?
Yeah, I just wanted to know exactly what that consisted of.
Charter One pays us about $18,000 a quarter for franchise fees.
How much a quarter?
Approximately $18,000.
Okay.
It's been on the uptick recently, but I stayed conservative and estimated the same as we got last year.
Okay, that's good.
Because it looks like we will most likely be ahead this current fiscal year, but with the economy, you never know. Because it's based on sales, of course.
And I saw the hall rentals.
They're going, wow. That's thanks to Weight Watchers and iCircle.
Yep.
Yeah.
And with the new chairs, perhaps that will entice others to want to.
I got Weight Watchers to give us a lot of revenue.
You know, get it for other events, graduation parties, christenings, whatever.
Any advertising for it?
They're losing by the time.
Perhaps Heather has, I'm not aware of any special advertising.
Would just like on our webpage or?
Probably, I'm sure that's on there, yes, as well as Facebook.
Hey.
AT&T and Verizon, T-Mobile are tower income, right?
Yes, they go up 3% each year. They don't, their leases aren't exactly on our fiscal years. They have various ending dates, and I keep up on those to make sure that we're on par with that.
So the T-Mobile, which is only up $60, is up overall the 3%, just showing up somewhere else?
No, that one was renegotiated and literally a year was dropped because whomever put together the agreement, it didn't take into account that it should increase, so it took what it was and doesn't renew until November this year.
Okay.
So we've lost a little bit there.
Yeah.
3%.
On page 3, the auditor, why did that go up so much?
Well, remember too, all the lines that you see that are in red does mean that they're combining lines. So the auditor line is now inclusive of the financial advisor, but it's also higher because of a couple items.
Yeah.
And that is, this year we will have to pay the audit itself is a total of overall between the two funds, $9,700. The AUD is $1,390. We have a deferred comp audit that is $1,881. We have to pay $2,900 for the single audit because we spent more than $500,000 on a state project, so the North Avenue Connector project.
Oh.
Lawrence, a $2,900 audit.
Yeah.
We have to pay the Burke Group for the GASB 45 actuarial evaluation of our employee benefits. That's something that's done every 3 years. And because of GASB 45, which was recently revamped, we will have to do this every 2 years. Not every 3 years, we'll have to do it every 2 years. I believe the cost for the next one will be lower slightly, but I can't confirm, I'm not 100% sure of that, but in this coming up fiscal year, we'll have to pay $3,150 for that, and then finally $3,600 for the financial services of our financial advisor Donigan. So that is why our total is about $22,000 for the two lines combined.
Wow.
I go back to page 2, and the new thing we had is equipment sales projection.
Yeah.
And
that's a purely Jake number.
Yeah, I know.
And he said this, if I can decipher his shorthand. Remember, we're finally into our third or fourth year of our equipment rotation program.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
So with that, we're going to sell things we got 4 years ago for almost the same price that we got it for.
Oh,
so consequently, we're in a good place now. We can rotate and get new stuff with exactly. So Jake said he was going to get in $93,000.
Right.
So that means we're going to get rid of W-15 for about $5,000, W-1 for about $29,000, W-2 for the same. The loader will be gotten rid of for $20,000, the mower for $6,000, and our gator for $1,000. So that'll bring us to $90,000. And then he's replacing, we've got $156,000 in the equipment line, and he's going to get a new W-15 because we're selling it, so we're gonna replace it. W-1 will be sold, we'll get another one for $35,000, W-2 for $36,000, mower for $15,000, and a utility Kubota for $18.5,000, which comes up to the $156,500.
Okay.
So he's anticipating $90,000.
Chris.
$6,000. $63,000.
Right.
Pay 300100.
What line are you on?
This is on page two, just below Jake's estimate. I see the state aid revenue share.
Jake said that was back on the table.
It is back on the table.
So why?
I haven't read or heard anything.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you're not on Facebook, Kurt.
So I put in $33,000.
Yeah.
$33,000.
Yeah.
The state aid.
In the governor's 30-day budget modification, it was back in a form, in a form. And that form is that the county receiving money through the, which hasn't passed yet, that internet sales tax, would then distribute to the towns on a formula that would go, that it has money to replace aid. So.
I kinda leave it here until you.
So it's kind of up in the air, it is. And you would hope that they would leave something in place that's been in place. And if they have a new source of revenue, that that would in fact maybe help to alleviate the problems that villages and towns have as an additional amount, but no. They'll use that to simply replace the, they've taken that, and that replacement will come from what they proposed to be new.
All right, so it's just a.
So that's a hope.
For the state, it's just a different line.
Seemingly, it's a hope.
Yeah, yeah.
Until the budget passes and whatever they do, whatever they pass.
I know, it's terrible.
And when do we fight him? Any idea?
It's April 1st, right?
Yeah.
So we still have a chance if we find, once we hear all that happens, we'll either pull or leave.
Yeah.
Well, is that, in the past, we've gotten 39, 38.
Yeah, but this past year, we got 33, that's why I projected 33, because it's not going to go back up. If anything, it'll go down.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So they'll know then.
April 1st, yeah. So by the time the budget's voted on, April 25th.
It's just a bureaucratic matter, you know, I mean, it's, state lines changing more than one time. Or it's going to.
But that takes us out.
Yeah.
Mine are on page three, I know you're combining computer assistance, website, computer hardware.
Yeah.
Seems a little high.
Well, you have to figure in at least a 5%, 3 to 5% increase on past services, so let's see.
It's not a big deal, it's like $3,000.
Well, I took $18,000, I took $15,000, and I believe if I had 3%, that's $18,000. $500 for the website, and $24,000, we have to add, we have to purchase two new workstations, $1,200 per workstation for computers. Two people need to be rotated out. I think Megan's one of the oldest ones, and then I believe Clancy needs to have one too. So that's about $1,200. for each of the workstations, plus any miscellaneous computer hardware that might need to be replaced in the transition. So that's why that's gone up from 9, 10. Yeah, 17. That's why it's up. That's why it's higher, because we only estimated 2,000 last year. This year it's 2,400 for workstations, and then a little higher for computer assistance.
How's the new computer system working?
It's going great.
3% of that.
Saving you a lot of time?
Yeah.
Good.
I'd like to drop that to 18.
Drop what? Computer assistance?
That line, that combined line of 21 to 18. We may save on one of the computer workstations, and we'll look at the rest of that. Computer assistance, that is for
LMT.
Okay. LMT?
Yeah. Well, you know, there's always hackers out there. You never know what's going to break. Joe's pretty in tune with the computer system, but there's some things that she can't figure out in LMT, especially with the hackers and the scams and the whatnot that goes on with the computers.
True, but we have purchased cyber insurance. So is that covered?
No. Cyber insurance is only effective if there's a hack into our program. That's what the cyber insurance is for. Cyber insurance won't fix our computer problems. Now just also keep in mind, we've already spent $15,000 on LMT this year. And by bringing it down to 18, that means we will not be able to replace any computers.
Can't replace any of the computers? What are you projecting for computer replacement? How much?
$2,400.
Well,
they're pricey now.
Does Clancy even need one? He's not even in there.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Oh.
He's on the road half the time. I mean, he's...
You can tell Clancy that.
Yeah, you can.
Not a problem.
How many people have... Has it been worked on this year?
Pardon?
Has it been worked on this year?
Clancy's?
Yes.
Yes, it has. By LMT recently.
So they did maintenance, like they would come into mine and take that mine?
Yes.
Mine is working fine. I wouldn't ask for a new one, but...
That's fine, so I will...
Let's go to 18 right now.
Okay.
If anybody wants to come back on that another day.
Office supplies, Chris?
Yeah, we kind of need to be careful on what we buy. Let's see, where are we?
So it's still on page 3 right in the middle.
Yeah, and they've combined GG Cash.
Oh, yeah, I see that.
Yeah, so the budget was 36.
Now you're at 5325. It's $1,200.
So averaging currently, we're spending $180 in office supply. $425 currently on office supplies. So I budgeted $400, hoping that...
Per month?
Per month.
Okay.
So I dropped it down to 400, hoping that we can make that dollar amount. And that includes in by 400 times 12 plus 525 brings you to the 5325.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Yeah. If you look at this year, the number is 28. We got 4 months to have a couple of people right at 4,000. That's a possibility.
What's that?
I said I may revisit that office supplies to $4,000 and $4,500, but we'll see. We're waiting on that. Traditionally, looking back at the history of the previous 2 years. I have a question on page four, and that would be, first of all, records retention.
Yes, that's $5,500 to transfer payroll records to digital versions, because the machine we have in our office currently is just about dead. So if we have a request from your state retirement or some attorney that's whose person's estate is in probate or whatever, we can't pull any payroll records because if the machine's not working. So if you care to put it off a year, I suppose we could do that, but then it will be more expensive if we wait another year.
So the $5,500 is for a machine?
No. It's to take about 20 microfiche cassettes, to digitize those into a format that can be read by any PDF program or Word document.
So is that part of what an office staff personnel will do during their work hours?
No, it's something to pay Image Integrator to take those and digitize them. We can't do that ourselves.
You can't do that. So no. This is sending this out?
Correct.
And this year we've only done 1,200?
Yes, because we were going to do more, but we borrowed that money to buy a new accounting program.
Right. Right. And that is important. Mm-hmm. That is good.
Then two down from that.
Cell tower construction?
No. Village hall equipment?
Equipment.
56.
Jake's got in there. $55,000 for the roof.
And a generator, right?
Yes.
And $1,500 for a water fountain for this room.
A what?
A water fountain.
A water fountain?
Correct.
Really?
Yes.
What's wrong with the one out there?
I don't know. We spent $3,000 on the one in the guy's break room. So $1,500 is a lot cheaper than the $3,000.
On an actual water fountain.
Correct.
So most organizations, I'll let Jake know, are taking water fountains away. They're actually a really terrible source of bacteria. So most schools and stuff have gone to water bubblers, you know. Yeah, yeah. So I'm not really sure why we're installing a drinking fountain.
That's the note that Jake has on here. $55 for the roof and $1,500 for the water.
I thought I saw it has some note, the room's generated for something.
I think that's been pushed off.
That's been pushed off?
Or maybe it's in the 72 that hasn't been spent yet in the current budget.
I don't know why you need a water fountain in here when you got one right outside.
No.
You typically wouldn't see a water fountain in a conference
room. No. I don't think that's going to be in here at all.
That's
got water right here. That's a cup and no good fountain.
Well, right, we got a kitchen.
Supply cups, that's cheaper. I say no to water fountain. I think that's $1,500, but.
Now, what's the generator?
He pushed it off, she said.
I believe that it's not been spent yet. I believe there's almost $73,000 in the current fiscal year. And only $15,000 of it's been spent. So I want to say the generator will be purchased in the next couple of months.
Yeah.
Which is 25, leaving still 50, so I'm likely to have an additional 50. So I don't have to answer that. Yeah. Okay. I would agree with you, Al, that that can come down a lot.
Yeah.
Can the water pump?
That's a small.
That's for sure.
That's yeah.
But yes.
But still,
yes,
every little bit helps.
Definitely.
Right.
Agreed. They can.
It's, yeah, I mean, it's,
yeah.
Pennies matter. I mean, it's, the roof we need.
Cell tower construction.
That is the retainage left on the amount due, that's the amount due to Fred Nutt. We held that amount back when they built, and if there's no issues by October 19th, that amount will need to be paid out to them.
Okay.
Was that previously budgeted for and we're simply holding it?
No.
What date? October?
Yeah, October. I don't have a specific, hold on. $10.31 is due by. And I take that back, it would be in an outstanding PO that was carried forward from the 18 fiscal year.
That's in a PO from this year.
Actually, from last fiscal year, not this one. It keeps rolling forward, but we still have to include it in the budget.
This was a shocker to me. Water, $3,000. Traditionally, historically, $1,400, $1,000.
Yeah.
It seems like we're over it this year, but the budget at 15, we're at 17, we're why 3,000. I believe that that can certainly drop down.
It can? The only thing I can think of is usage. I haven't looked specifically at the cost, but I can certainly do that.
Yeah, one of the things that they're doing every day is putting those tanks and hitting those flowers every single day. In fact, even coming in on the weekend. And maybe they could go every 2 days. I don't know if we could cut back. If that's part of the water issue, I don't know where we're using all the water.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I questioned that last summer. I'm not sure why we water every single day, Saturday, Sunday. You don't do that at your own home.
No.
So I was curious as well.
Well, it depends on what the content of the soil is in those planters. Maybe it's draining quicker than it's...
Well, they should, because they get those the baskets are supposed to come with a liner, which is so water retentive.
Right.
So they shouldn't be. So
and there's a lot of
this
water.
Is something that I think we need to consider and come back to.
Well, if you water them Friday afternoon, they should be able to go Saturday or Sunday or Monday.
Yeah.
Okay.
So electric, we're already at 8123.
Yeah, there are 4 months to go.
Five.
Well, you had 131, so...
Sorry, you're actually correct. 4 months.
4 months.
But that January figure doesn't necessarily include the January bill, because they bill late. So I'm pretty sure that that January dollar amount doesn't include January usage. So we really have January, February, March, April, and May, so there's 5 months to go.
I think further on there's street lights.
There is, 5182.
Yes, and I see that went up to 93, and we're at 53 right now. We budgeted 90 and 91, but I would think that we would have a decrease with a number of things. One with the new purchasing that we have for the electric, and also with the LEDs that have gone in. So I'm not exactly sure why that went up to 93.
Because it took an average of what's currently been spent. And to
tell you the truth, 3% again?
Correct. I actually didn't take into account a large price increase. I just took into account what we've currently spent. So currently, based on 7 months, we're spending about $75.59 a month. So I took $7,600 as an average for our monthly total. And to tell you the truth, up until, I have not seen any decrease in the electricity. Even though we went to the county, there really hasn't been a significant change, savings really. Savings in time, we're not going through.
I thought, yeah.
Because we're, savings in time, because we're not going through 12 different bills. It's all on one bill now, so that's a savings. But as far as monetary savings on the bill, I honestly haven't seen much of a savings. Yes.
No reason to go LED.
There really hasn't been a savings.
Great point. There's no point in it, the point I saved. I wouldn't finish the program.
When I did a side-by-side comparison, and I can certainly do that and email it to all of you for, I can do an annual for just the streetlights. You'll see there really isn't a difference. Really isn't a difference.
I'm surprised.
I'll pull that together for you tomorrow and send it off to you.
Okay.
Will it be sufficient if I do it from January 1 of 18 through January of this year? Will that be good?
Good enough.
Gerald, that go, okay?
I mean, maybe this year we're not going to save it because of the cost of the LEDs.
Well, I don't even take that into consideration. I'm just looking at energy costs. Energy costs. And I really have not seen a reduction at all.
Yeah, I really expect it to be good.
I'll run that for you and send it off tomorrow.
Because I think it was photo cell.
What?
Yeah, so I think if it starts to dark, it'll probably, you see.
Talk about the lights.
Talking about the lights.
Well, that's what I know, but I couldn't hear what he was saying.
And there's one on that's on all the time, and that's the one right in front of Village Hall.
I know.
All the time. And a lot of the other lights have been on during the day as well.
Yeah, we have one on Laughlin's, yeah.
Yeah.
Because didn't we think that the consumption was going to be different if we had the LEDs?
Yes.
Wasn't that part of why we went to them?
Streetlights are not metered.
Didn't we have a study?
They're flat rate.
I thought there was something.
They're not metered, well.
They're flat rate.
You think that's it?
Streetlights are not metered. They're flat rate.
Well, there's kilowatt hours on the bills.
Yeah.
So they should be giving you a lower rate on those streetlights. But streetlights are not metered. They're flat rated. They just come off the RG&E lines.
So we must have to tell them.
So if they are not updated, their records, you are still paying the old flat rate.
So you're saying we should be paying a flat rate as opposed to a per kilowatt hour rate?
Right.
Yeah, because streetlights are not metered.
But if we're changing.
They run off.
That's just how it is, you're saying?
Yeah, streetlights normally run off.
I think we missed.
Off whatever the line is that they're on.
Miss a step where we probably should let RG&E know what we've done.
Right, they'll give you a better rate.
I bet you that they stuck with the old rate because it's there.
Yeah, because streetlights are just off the line. They're not, they don't put an individual meter on every streetlight.
Well, it's metered just down on South Avenue. Over here.
Yeah.
Farther.
All right.
Okay, so, yeah, I mean, we should contact RG&E and tell them what we're done because I don't think that they're just sending a bill for the way it always was. Unless we tell them what changed. And any electric is basically metered, but what happens is the overall meter that sits in the station down on South Avenue there.
This is where RG&E
was. I know.
He'll be here next Thursday. First of all, I can see some of the cuts we proposed. Real awesome.
Oh, he will. Oh, yes, he will.
So what?
Yeah.
Hey, if anybody's, quick, just a quick note, small cells, there's one at the corner of Fuller and Dunning. There's a gray house on the northeast corner. In that backyard, and there's a double pole situation right up by Fuller Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
There's one up there, a black two. So somebody jumped out and put one in.
You contacted the private owner?
I saw it today.
It's private.
No, that's right away. It's public right away.
How was it? Do the poles?
And I don't want to take any more time, but we all assume that these pods that are coming out are going to be on top of the poles. They're not. They're down.
I don't know. No one's assuming the top. They actually explained.
I did.
Oh, no, they explained when they were here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ground, they can't be more than 50 feet, right?
Right.
Off the ground.
Yep.
Just for your FYI, there's one there. It looks like just a gray tube that's up above his elbow. So.
Manuals, page 5, Chris, 479, combined there to 750. We're purchasing a lot of manuals. We haven't purchased
page
any.
Page 4?
Page 5. And it's line 360.
Yeah. Will doesn't normally spend money in his line at all. He hasn't spent the 475 given to him, but he has, he needs some books for his building inspection job, so he's asked for 750.
I have one more still on page 4.
Page 4?
I'm sorry. Dues on page 4.
Page 4.
I see 5,100.
That combines all the
all of those. Okay.
In the
I'm sorry.
All of the village.
Yep. Yep.
NICOM, Chamber of Commerce, LaFarge.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
The whole kit and caboodle. One line.
Page 5, question. What's that safety inspection personnel?
That's Will.
Will.
Is that Will? That's Will.
With a 3% increase.
Yep.
All right, because I'm just looking at what we spent. Here today, 37.
He's 35 hours, so 35 hours times 52 weeks is X number of dollars hours times his rate brings you to 60.96.
I was just looking at the number there. Well, what we've spent here today, 8 months, is we can get away with 55 on there, I thought, but.
You want to tell him to reduce his hours, please?
No, based on...
I took the number of hours, 35, times 52 weeks.
He's only used 37 so far in 8 months.
You can still take vacation and sick time, which would be included in that 35 right, hours.
Right.
So I'm just
no, that's all right.
Yeah,
that's
telling
right.
you how it is, that's all.
Yep.
So 35 times 52, and then the bumped up rate of 3302 per hour brings you to 60.96.
11.56 a week.
I'm on page 6. So what's that snow removal contractual?
That would include.
Say that. that's a big jump to $2,000.
Well, because again, we're combining lines. $3,142, so it's up.
She made it in red, so you can see.
No, it's not red.
No, it's not red. $2,000. That was a Jake change. I didn't estimate that much. Jake changed it.
$1,000.
Let's see. Let's see what he said in there.
Yeah.
I don't have an explanation.
$1,000.
Let me see what Jake had. Hold on a second.
The other is snow removal personnel. I would go right back to $90,000, but last year I would increase it to $93,600.
But remember, let me just, hold on. Yeah, I don't have an explanation for the $2,000.
We already, we changed it.
To how much?
$1,000.
$1,000, okay.
So go up two lines.
Now remember, the $93,600, remember our discussion, the previous workshop. We have a pool of money. We took all payroll lines and increased them by 4%. So this is part of that total pool of money that's paid to all of our guys. If it's not used in this line, it'll be used for landscape or parks and rec. So it's not really, you're not really reducing this line, you're reducing the pool of money that will really be spent one way or another. So we've got, let's say it's a lot more than $50,000, but we're taking $50,000 and dividing it up by all the payroll lines. So just because you reduce this line, then technically you should increase another line, because you're not going to reduce payroll because the guys are still going to all work 40 hours a week. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it's just salary increases.
Because remember, then, too, I mean, we can work all we want on the budget, but stuff happens, and we could get three huge snowstorms next year, and this line will be out of the water. Or we're going to have a really wet summer, and the guys are going to be doing this, that, and the other thing in storm sewers or whatever. So if it's not used in one place, it's used to compensate the line that was under budgeted for. Because it's all a pool of money that's divided equally among the different departments.
Well, does it show in the...
Let's reduce road tax.
Well, he obviously has a plan for buying a piece of equipment that's probably just...
That's four from the bottom on page six.
In terms of what he has on here, he has North Side East Main Street excludes village labor and 108K and CDBG.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's doing the North Side of East Main,
right.
And he's going to get about $86,000 in CDBG funds. Excuse me, $108,000 in CDBG grants.
Right, that's what he's asked for.
Yeah.
So he's looking to spend beyond that $146,000?
No, I believe the difference, I mean, you have to account for both. He's going to spend $150,000 but get $108,000, so we're really only going to spend $42,000 or thereabouts. That's how I understood it. Yeah, he's saying $146,000 and he's asked for $108,000 or something like that.
So $108,000 coming in.
Mm-hmm.
From the federal aid. $108,289.
You're on income?
What page?
Yeah. Page two.
Oh, okay.
The second one from the bottom.
Federal aid?
Right.
108, that's what it is. Yeah, that 108 against the 148, so we'd really be spending 40.
Mm-hmm.
But you've got to spend the 148 before you get the 108.
There you go.
if you're also still on page two, you'll also notice that usually for chips, we would get about $96,000. They've reduced those funds, and we're only estimated to get about 84 this year. And it's been consistently 96 every previous year, so they're cutting that by 12 grand.
Chris?
How about if we go back to line 5142430, road and salt?
What page are you on?
Page six. 5142430. And go back to 18.
Sure.
20. Let them be a little bit more conservative. Maybe just as they reach an intersection, go through the middle of it and do it instead of do it, turn the corner, come back, spray it again, go in the other way.
Don't we do sensible soaping now?
No.
Is that right, John?
No.
Sensible salting?
I thought we did that.
Sensible if we see piles of salt.
I haven't seen that.
No.
I think when they first pull a gate open, that's when you see the pile.
On the county street, maybe drive down the hill and up the hill.
Don't ask me about my driving life. So how do you know how to do it? So you're saying I drive through the village.
Probably more than right, road.
Sometimes it happens when they open the gate for the salt.
Sometimes maybe if you're backing out.
Then you get a pile.
Don't turn the spinner off and you stop for a second. You might send it out and drop a pile.
Yeah,
right
there.
It's going to dump.
If you're turning yourself around, but
that's not going to happen.
But anyway, they can...
Get your shovel, throw it back in the truck.
You know what? And if we need it, we can find it and move it.
Chris?
Yes, sir.
I see on page 7, tree removal, pruning, and trimming is combined. And so we estimate 25,000, but I'm a little confused about this. Does that come out of page 6, 93.6? Snow removal personnel? I mean, you said that was a pool.
25,000 for pruning?
Yes.
Pruning is 406. Payrolls are all 100 lines?
Sure.
Okay. Yep.
So all the 100 lines combined, if you look at the summary I gave you last workshop, all of those lines were combined, upped by 4%, and then divided up throughout the budget. So if you decide to reduce payroll for snow plowing, you're not really reducing that payroll line.
Yeah, okay.
You're reducing the total of payroll, which really can't be done because of the union contract. So
I misunderstand you.
Right.
You should have been a CPA.
Question on page 8. Park facility repairs, 7140433.
Jake requested.
Spent this year, but historically, 800 and 900, and now we're at $4,000. Any idea on the projection of why we need to spend that?
I believe. Most recently, we did some backstops in one of the parks. That's what that kind of stuff includes, is working.
Well, that's done.
Pardon?
I said we won't be doing that this year.
Okay.
If they've done backstops. The park that really needs to get opened up, everybody, is the one that's over at Indian Village.
Yeah.
That needs to be utilized.
Wilmarite.
Yeah.
And it is not being utilized, and all I hear is, the neighbors complain about parking there and going back there. Well, it's not their private domain, it is the Webster Village Park. So we have to think about that. I have a feeling it's being utilized quite a bit because the housing now in the town is much right up to it, and I don't think there's much of a barrier anymore there. So it's probably being used, but not by us.
What do you want to decrease it to?
Personally, I'd like to see that drop down at least to maybe 25 or three.
Three.
I mean, if they've spent a lot of money on backstops, they're done. There's no more backstops to do. They don't do anything with the tennis courts, and the park grant got shot down. So I'm not sure what they're looking to do. So let's go to three. How about that?
Let's go to three.
Let's go with that.
Can you jump back to seven, and what are the plans?
That's a combination of everything.
A combination of the plants and baskets and plants?
Yes.
So we spent about 400 in plants and baskets in 13-4?
We made 13-4 from 6410 and 7,100 from parks. So parks was 7140 is parks. So the amount of money there for plants was $1,500 was in parks. So I took 1,000 from there and
hang on, what line?
I'm on the
page 7,
6410-402 line plants.
Right.
Yes, and I'm trying to explain that that now combines plants from both of the parks plants and the plants and baskets of that line. So 6410 plus 7140, which is further down. We're going to combine it to one line. So the plants that go in the parks and the plants that go around the village on the poles. And
so I wouldn't know that by looking at this, though, that you're combining those.
No.
Okay.
You'd only notice that the line 7140-432 further down was reduced by 1,000, and it was moved upstairs.
Peter and I ended up with an awful lot of grant information when we went to that one conference in Albany. And he and I are going to sit down and we're going to dissect everything that we have because these people really want to help us. So I don't know once we get that information whether we give it to Matt or we do something with it. I mean, we've got names of people that really want to give villages money. For a variety of things.
Well, you explained to me that they share, villages are sharing, sharing the person to help them execute
this. Oh, yeah, we've got, there were like three different people that we talked with that gave us their cards and said, please, you know. So I don't know whether we're going to do it or we have Matt do it. Because we were losing out if we don't have the paperwork for it.
Right, or kind of tap in a resource that's there.
Well, exactly.
And share with other municipalities.
They will, Yeah, because they told us they'd show us how to fill everything out to our best advantage and everything. So they do have grant money they want to give us. Yes, and we just don't know exactly which way we're going to go.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
Because one of the biggest things I hear sitting in one of the five entities is that, with the exception of the bid, but possibly and or chamber, who sort of sits in on things and doesn't really, the way they profit, but they don't. School district and the town went up quite a bit.
Yeah.
And look at us, and I said, no, this is where we are. So, we had talked about going down to 15.
And they did go down the year before.
We did.
Okay.
I would put something in place, I think, for...
Yeah, I was just asking a question because I know Judy had mentioned that process. And
I do think if you have materials available, I mean, we Will does do some things, but that's different. It's for the county, it's for the sidewalks, it's the CDB.
I know.
But if you're looking at the state one, maybe Matt should be the one, because he does have some experience. The grant that he got for the $500,000 for, you know, that has opened up a number of businesses there, so. But I agree with you. We have things that are available.
Yeah.
Pass it up.
Yeah.
We're just kind of crazy with politics right now, but we'll do that.
The planters, I understand that we're looking at planters for South Avenue, but we're looking at planters primarily for the island on there. And I don't see, if we look back historically, when we bought them all in 1617, why we're spending $7,500 right now.
Because he wants to buy them for the island.
I think there's enough that we could spread out.
But we have all over the village, if you look at them and count them.
Sometimes you see three, or too many together.
Yeah.
I agree with you.
Yeah, I do too.
But I mean, that can be cut back significantly.
Yeah. Those planters could all be utilized.
I mean, I can see some others, I can see some, but I don't see 70, but looking at what we bought at 32.
But I think you have enough that.
Yeah, well, what's the difference?
You can make that a little half.
So let's go back.
There's three pots in every.
Well, I'm just trying to see if we put anything in here that.
New planters, island, North Avenue, three large and six smaller, included self-watering and shipping included.
But your self-watering is something you put in it, so. Well, I would cut that back.
13.
To what?
I said 13, but 14 would be more logical.
No, we're buying new stuff though.
I would go back maybe to about three, take out $4,500 or something like that.
I don't know what your estimates are on that stuff.
I don't have the estimate in front of me, he just said that he's waiting on a confirmation of that estimate for the $7,500.
What about like $4,000? For now, until we want.
I'd go four for right now.
That was interesting.
Jerry made a good point as far as some of those planters, you see three of them piled up, one on top of the other. We can spread them out. And I think the gazebo on North Avenue needs a couple of plants too.
Yeah, better come over and pretty sure.
Somewhere in the band shell too.
Yeah.
Band shell.
That's.
Well, that's where that line park facility repairs comes in. It costs money to paint and repair, so if you reduce that, you're not going to repair the band shell.
Right, and it needs a test though, right?
Yeah, I would probably do that. If you've been to the band shell, there's no lighting underneath it.
Oh, no, I was just saying, we got those extra planters, you bring one over there and spruce up all that.
I'll take that with last.
Well, there's just some repairs that are really needed.
Those plants would be borrowed.
Don't see that.
The other one that we could look at are the plants as well, so I think that's an issue that we can come back to.
So we're at $4,000.
They're combining together the two lines, right, Chris? $8,560, $434, those two are combined, is that correct? On page seven?
Yes. Tree removal and pruning and trimming are together.
Yes.
So $21,000, $22,000.
Is it contractual or village?
I
Sorry?
We're up to 30 now, 22 to 30.
Is it by contract, or is it village?
Contractual. It's Birchcrest or whoever else is contracted out.
For what? The removal?
Yes.
Yes, and we go to Birch. They did a couple of things that they never should have done.
Yep.
And I don't know if we need to look around and maybe find another one, why we're stuck on Birch.
Yeah.
But we seem to be.
They did.
Lapham.
Yes.
Lapham Park, that was terrible.
We seem to be stuck on this company.
They removed trees that weren't supposed to be removed, so, yeah.
Well, it must have been bid out, right?
I mean, trimming and the pruning.
Usually there, but why don't we rebid that? Why don't we put that out to bid again?
We can.
Well, they do every year. And they always just basically choose one that's expensive typically.
So Birchcrest comes in low every year?
Yeah, they always have three quotes because it's a big job. I have to look at the PO, but there's always.
Does the bid come to you?
Yes, they do.
You need to look at it. Are we leaving the plants and baskets at 7?
Well, we got those extras.
Got the extras, all right. Bob, we remember, we don't plant those planters. That's the.
I know.
Right, so we're staying at 17.
Well, we do have the ones that are going, and we have to make a decision on those too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because there are 30 poles, we cannot put 60 new baskets there. They have two brackets, so we're going to either have to decide on one on each one or skipping poles.
You can do every other pole once.
We can do every other pole.
Places do that.
That's what I thought.
Two on every other pole?
No.
No, one on every.
Rotate every other pole. Rotate. Flowers on one.
We'll rotate.
Small cell on another.
Well, you can always paint the cell to look like, you know, something flashy, you know. Caribbean color, do something.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Last one before we get to the silver.
20 minutes.
Page 9. Storm sewer equipment. Is there something there for storm sewer equipment?
Gutter replacements with road rehabilitation.
140-200.
The 15,000 is for gutter replacements.
Got it.
Yeah.
Oh, it's on my street.
I can tell you where it's planned on being done.
That's good. Reasonable.
Gutters are on Champion.
Here, it's down here, gutter replacements are not included with roofs, road rehab. I have a question on something to do with you.
What?
I'm sorry?
Road rehab.
Road rehab. He has a comment that it was not included, the gutters were not included, you know, digging out the sides and rehabbing them on in his road rehab. So if you take a look at $5,112,425. Major road repair. It is
five.
Page.
Bottom.
What?
Five. Bottom.
Materials micro paid. Major road repairs. Street paint. And on and on. $366,000. $367,000. And his note is, he wants to pay Curtis Fuller to the curb. And I don't understand, I thought we paid Curtis, I And I thought we paved Fuller, and I don't understand what to the curve.
No, they stopped, they had to go from Main Street and Curtis to Fuller. That is rough through there, that cut through there. Yeah, from the church around the bend to Fuller. They did Curtis from Fuller on.
Okay, so they didn't do the lower part?
Yeah.
Woodstone, Kircher, the east end of Reynolds, and micropave as listed, and I don't know where that is, then Donovan Skin.
Micropave is Champion, Judson, London, and micropave two is Dunning, Baker, Lyon, Pierce, Sanford, May, Mary, Vale, Daniel, and Dean.
Wow.
And then Ship.
Well, Harry does a repair on Lapham because it's falling apart.
The Lapham's on here too for paving.
Yes.
So I don't think we must have been on maintaining that, so we're going to be in bigger debt.
I'm just asking what they were.
By all means, sir, that was a good question.
Al, could you just drop his chair down?
And I will ask Jake, because he's got topsoil and seed and screening, and he's got it in like three different places, and I wish it would consolidate together rather than all over the place, so we'll have to ask him.
Well, it's kind of hard to do that, though, from the perspective that if you've got topsoil in, sometimes you need topsoil in your DPW department, sometimes you need your topsoil in your parks. Mm-hmm. So it's two different areas, and that's why it's separated.
Well,
just like payroll separated.
If he's spending on seed, he needs to spend it on a little bit better quality seed, because the only thing that grows out of the seed that they plant is garbage.
Yeah, it is. Park Avenue terrible. Looked terrible.
Park looked terrible. Elm.
Wow.
Who was out? There was on Lapham every day almost pulling.
Yes. Yeah, yes. You could eat that.
Junk.
You're froggy. Do you know what? I caught you eating McDonald's for dinner. I think you guys cut that out.
I agree with Daryl.
I'm sorry. I got a place to visit. I'm going to vent.
The neighbors on Park Avenue didn't love that particular strip.
Right. We know. They come through every year and do the edges of the sidewalk.
Well, when they did our sidewalks, and they messed up our sidewalks.
The weeds come with the topsoil, not the seed.
Probably.
It
that
could
too.
Be. But the seed is really weeds.
Weed seeds.
All right. Let's go to sewer. Run to the sewer.
Which sewer? Let's cut up sewer here.
Here, James is going.
We had $4,700 combined for topsoil and seed. I think we need a compost again and down at the
Oh, would that be? Oh, I love it.
Man, he's on fire.
Or off-site.
Yeah. Oh, we're thinking about that too.
Boy, those retired guys are taking a lot of money away.
That's what happens. That's what happens.
103.
Yeah. No, is the retirement money? Well, that's not just the retirement people. You know what that is, right?
Heather wants to know what time the pizza's coming.
Should be. Is it in the budget?
7:30.
We're taking a seed buy.
That'd be where it should come out. I would agree with you. I would not argue with you.
I got one thing on sewer. Page 4.
Oh, I know. We got to do that.
I got one on.
Lay it
on. Sludge hauling landfill. That's a John question.
I hit that too. You're at 15 with 5 months left.
The previous year's 21, 26, now it's 35.
Well, before we could get rid of our own sludge, now we can't.
Right,
well, we didn't in 2016.
Yeah. We got rid of our sludge at the plant.
Yeah.
We can't do that anymore. That's why it's costing more. Right, John?
Yeah, I mean, every time we get rid of sludge, we gotta get a roll-off down there. And the roll-off, we have a Castell come in, and each roll-off can only hold maybe 15 tons.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes up to 18 tons, but usually around 15. And, you know, we're gonna be using all, whatever's left, is 15 left or whatever, whatever's left, we're gonna be using that up before June, because we ran into a little issue where we had a stockpile for about 3 months because the permits at landfill.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah,
they
yeah.
They switched over the computer system and everyone had to redo their profiles.
Yeah.
And so we didn't really haul out for probably, I'd say, 2 to 3 months. So I'm down, but our digester says get rid of the sludge.
Okay.
So.
How often do you haul? Is it daily, monthly, weekly?
No, it's...
Or by...
It's always in the...
Amount. It's by amount, right?
It's by amount. You know, we'll run the centrifuge for, you know, maybe 5 days or so. Maybe 6 days to get a load. It's all by amount. So we run it on as needed, as our digester solids get high. You know, then we got to run it more often. And, you know... Be nice to try to, you know, some months we might have to do 2 loads, some months
well,
we might
recently,
try to do 1 load.
Well, like recently we paid Casella $6,500.
Yeah.
Average, we paid DEC, we paid Casella again, $1,300. Seneca Meadows, $1,100.
Yes.
And that's only in 1 month. So in 1 month we spend $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, $9,000, almost $12,000.
Well, it's more, right? It's more than before, right? Because
waste
management wasn't that expensive, right?
We can't get rid of it now.
Waste management, they're still up there.
You're going
to
Fairport's
for a while also, we were driving our trucks. You know, we have a 364 hauler permit.
It makes a huge difference.
And we were driving our trucks, but our trucks are not equipped to go to the landfill, especially Seneca Meadows.
Yeah.
And our trucks, it's a hike, and, you know, our truck's like a pickup truck for the trucks that go up there. And it's just, I mean, you know, we definitely have a hauler permit, we definitely can haul. I did also, I got approval to go to, out to Stanley. Casella has a landfill up on 5 and 20.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I got approval to go there. So right now we're good to go there Seneca Falls. Seneca Meadows.
Would it be any less than Odinadega, or does it matter?
Well, Casella. Casella's our hauler. And Casella bought out, WeCare, the trucking part of it. So, and Casella also owns Stanley, the landfill on Stanley. So, you know, they'll take it to either or. Casella is like they're a big company out of Vermont that's buying up all the smaller.
We're expanding out here. They're coming.
Smaller rubbish places.
Yeah.
But like I say, so we do have a 364 we can haul, but you almost need a driver for that. Plus, it takes a lot of time, hours and all that. You know, if you go up to Seneca Meadows, if you go up there, you know, you might go up there, you might be there 7 hours.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times what happens up there, because we're small, we're in the village of Webster, we're not the trucking companies that go up there all the time. You know, you go there, you go off to the side, and they almost forget about you. But it definitely, without composting, it costs money to get rid of sludge.
Mm-hmm. That's terrible.
So there's got to come a point when Seneca Meadows, you know, is done and doesn't want it anymore. That's why it's nice to go to Stanley also. But you know, they're going to top off at some point, and then I don't know what we're doing with our sludge.
This was a terrible decision that we had to make.
Now it's in the same situation,
isn't it? The town also uses, they also take theirs to landfill. Mm-hmm. They go through a lot more sludge than we do, though.
Well, yeah, we got 5,000 people, they got 50,000. Yeah, really
right.
Different.
Well, the difference, they're going to be in the same situation.
Oh, sure.
For sure.
So you're saying, and this is the sludge hauling to the landfill?
Sludge hauling to the landfill.
35.
I'm hoping, once they get caught up, I'm hoping 35 should go.
I don't see why it wouldn't, because 26, 21, and now 15 right now, and you're going to catch up.
So.
Yeah, but you'll also notice that that line's been cut from 26 to 21, not one, only because we've had expenses from Novella.
Yes.
And that was the line I thought I could take from.
Yep.
But that means they only have $6,000 left to use for the rest of the fiscal year, which probably will fall short.
What do you know for these?
There's only six in the sludge line?
Yep.
After the, yeah. Probably need that money back.
Yeah, yeah. I'll call Novella.
Okay.
You asked me about grease.
Grease.
Yes.
$6,800.
Yeah, I wanted to know about that.
I saw.
It's a daily version.
$6,800.
And I understand that it combines a couple of lines, but if you look at those lines, there's not $6,800.
No.
I don't see any combination.
We put a little, well, because the line is called other, it's for other things. Right, John?
We're under contingency.
Hold on. Page four, down by the bottom there. The grease.
Greasing down.
470, about three quarters of the way down.
Well, I mean, like you said, 470 includes.
A lot of things.
A lot of things. So, I mean, the grease part of it, you know, would only be our tubes of grease and our spray grease. It used to be, I think.
It's a lot of tubes.
Well, because it includes, it's not just grease. It includes multiple lines, so of course it's not $6,800 worth of grease.
I apologize, I didn't make that red for you.
There's somebody down there.
Wait a minute, Chris.
Okay, wait a second, hold on. I've got an explanation for that line. Hold on. I just needed to get my bearings here. Okay. Process logic computer. We need to spend $3,000 to get a new computer for the sewage treatment plant, which is the computer that...
We just got a computer now.
No. The computer to drive the entire clarifiers, all that stuff.
Is that written in our assessment?
Pardon? That's why it's $6,800. So $3,000 plus the other regular maintenance amounts there would makes up the $6,800.
What's running it now?
A program, a computer that needs to be replaced. That's very old. It's not been replaced in 5 years, to the best of my knowledge.
Okay.
No. It's the computer that was put in when they put the new program in.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
How long ago was that?
Specifically runs the program, because you don't have a new program, so it specifically runs it.
So is that an actual price?
Yes. Yeah, I have a quote from Process Logic. Total project cost $2,500 plus there's all kinds of parts and whatnot, materials that need to be purchased. So the total comes to $3,000.
Tell me the line vehicle maintenance, John. What does that include?
Is it 8130?
Yep.
Is it 8130?
8130, yeah,
of course. 8130 would be the van, it'd be the Bobcat, it'd be the mower, it'd be the gator, it'd be any.
Is that part of the sewer? Yeah.
Part of the sewer. You know, it wouldn't include the flush truck. The flush truck would be 8120 for vehicle maintenance.
So W16. W-16 was $1,500, $1,900. Right now it's $2,000 in terms of vehicle maintenance. You had $4,000. I'd like to drop that to $3,000. That would be line 812420.
And it's basically up there. I mean, that's a older truck, and when things go wrong with it, it could be...
They're expensive.
Costly.
We've already spent $1,500. When the year's not over.
Yeah. Talk to Jake, put it into his vehicle replacement.
Yeah. And we looked at it somehow.
Well,
I've already looked.
Because he's the one who said these things will reduce our maintenance. Well,
I mean, that's obviously, that's one I've looked at. I've talked about needing a new truck for the past probably 10 years.
Yeah.
I know I've gotten quotes for them. I've gotten lease information. I've had demos come out all the time. You know, they can be costly, but there are smaller. Vector has one that Williamson has that I'm waiting to go out and take a look at. It's a smaller version of what we have. But I mean, you know, those trucks can be $480,000. So obviously I'm not looking for that kind of truck. But still, even smaller versions are still $380,000, $360,000 But, you know.
So he's looking to swap out trucks, though. Is there anything that's comparable in terms of what he's looking to do in vehicle swap-outs?
From Jake's?
From Jake, yes, because this is not just a sewer truck. This is a village truck that is used down at the sewer. So it doesn't necessarily have to come under your line. It could come under Jake's line.
I mean, you know, the sewer truck would be a great thing to get if we go to the next step of the deal with the sewer department. That'd be a fantastic thing to get at that point. There's also, there's a piece of equipment I'm looking, I have a demo coming up in May. It uses radio signals in between manholes, and it's, you know, you can, they say you can go through, you can inspect about 9,000 feet a day, and it gives you like a, breakdown in, you know, a 10 down to zero. You know, maybe a 10 is meaning it's, there's a block in the line, you should address it. A 5 might be, you know, it's okay. And it basically breaks it down. And EPA did a huge study on it, and, you know, was pretty impressed with it. It's good for, you know, saving, because a lot of municipalities don't exactly have the manpower and all that, and it costs a lot to go out and flush the lines and keep them out. And this thing here, you could go out and test your system and know where your trouble spots are and where. Just to hit those, you know, you still want to do maintenance and clean the lines. But for us to go out and flush our entire system takes a long time, and, you know, it takes some good man hours. So this is a system that, you know, again, down the road, I think it'd be, it'd definitely be a, it's, you know, I got a quote on it. It's $26,000. But like I say, they're coming out in May to do a demo. And so let's see how it goes.
Yeah.
So are we changing the 424 or 420 line to 3?
All right, we have a pretty good beginning, I guess. Come back to this revisit, we'll have Jake here.
Yeah.
And we'll revisit in a week and a half. In that time, Chris, you can update the lines that we talked about tonight. And we'll be good to go. We'll also have to talk about maybe considering the sewer rates.
Yeah.
Anything else that we consider increasing the revenue line? Right? Okay, anybody else have anything they'd like to talk about then? If not, Jerry's gonna get home and have dinner. And it is 7:40, I think, 7:36. So thank you all for coming. Can I have a motion to adjourn?
I make the motion.
I'll say.
All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carried. Thank you all very much.
We just closed out a couple of questions. One of them, which is prime. Prime being the ambulance room.
Nine.